Hello everyone, I'm Dimple Rangeela and today we are going to talk about language development through drama, theatre or play in a classroom. Drama is not new for children. We often see children imitating cartoon or film characters or playing games like Mother Father, Doll's Marriage, School, etc. In this manner, during games that children play, they do drama like imitating someone, exaggerating something, or maybe making excuses. As the saying goes, tell me and I will forget, show me and I will remember, involve me and I will understand. This way, drama is used in classroom to make the child involved in the activities. Every child has dramatic skills, but children do not get an opportunity to utilize them in their classroom. The reason for this is that activities like drama acting are performed only during annual functions or when some chief guest is visiting the school. Even in such situations, dialogues are written by teachers and there is always a risk factor during the performance. But what today we are going to talk about is when these scripts are written by children, adapted by them and then performed by themselves. Making use of acting as a day-to-day activity in a classroom is very different from this. In order to use drama as a linguistic activity, two characteristics need to be included, which are freedom and enjoyment. That means the child needs some autonomy to adapt the story into a particular kind of the script the way they want, who will perform what kind of role, and it should be an enjoyable activity for the children and not something which is forced upon them. No special preparation is needed by the teacher or children for conducting drama in the classroom. The teacher only needs to encourage the children to share their experiences naturally. At the primary level, any incident, a story or a cartoon that children see in their environment can be taken up for acting. For example, any animal, its movement, etc. At the upper primary level, the teacher should motivate children so that they form small groups wherein they themselves decide the topic, write the dialogues and act it out. So it can be any theme. For example, if it is Ganesh Utsav, the children can be given a told a story about the same and then they can ask to write the dialogues, form the script and then act it out. At the same time, children should also be encouraged to act out traditional games and folk tales, as this will not only enhance their creativity but also connect them to their cultural environment. So, if we share with them stories, folk tales, rhymes, riddles and songs that have been there that form the culture of childhood, these can also be incorporated in their drama and the role play. All these activities will lead to development of empathy, wherein the child will put himself or herself in the shoes of the other person and they would know how the other person is feeling. That means they empathize. It creates a culture of listening. It is very important for children to be good listeners as well. So when they'll be seeing other children perform, they would know that they have to listen to be able to understand and grasp the story. When we are giving them a drama to perform in a group, then it becomes a collaborative and a collective action. All the children will join together, form dialogues, they will decide who will play what character, who is going to be the narrator and how they are going to do the whole drama. So it provides them with opportunities for initiative taking, leadership and the group dynamics can also be observed. It provides medium for dramatic play, a medium for sharing and self-expression of feelings, concerns and ideas. So they also get an expression. It enhances understanding and awareness of the self. So not only of the other person, but even of the self. And it is one of the most child-friendliest pedagogy that can be used with children for them to be able to express themselves freely. It makes the classroom inclusive as children from all diverse backgrounds, they would be able to come together and put a show up. It helps to reach out to all children, addresses diversity based on the language, gender, different abilities of children. Also helps in role identification because children will get to know what role a person plays. Drama gives children opportunities to explore, discuss and deal with difficult issues and to express their emotions in a supportive environment. Since all this while the teacher will be around these groups of children, she can act as a facilitator and guide. So if the children get stuck somewhere, to decide what kind of perspective they should take at a particular point in a story or in their script, she can help them to explore those options. It enables them to explore their own cultural values and those of the past and that of the present. It encourages them to think and act creatively, thus developing critical thinking and problem-solving skills that can be applied in all areas of learning. Through drama, children are encouraged to take responsible roles and make choices to participate in and guide their own learning. Teachers can take a more open-ended approach, concentrating on the process of learning at least as much as, if not more, than the product. So, the teachers in this case would be more focused on the process of learning, the way the drama, the script of the drama has been prepared, how the children are working together in the group, and how they try to enact the whole story in the form of a drama, but not at the product. Now, few ideas and quick games that can be used as themes. So we can give them any of these, a day in the life of any person. It can be any animal, an insect, a bird. So we can leave it to their own imagination how they will think about how about a day in the life of a monkey. So what all does a monkey do in a whole day? So they can think about it and enact it. Changing shapes. Children are given a pretend shape to hold, for example, a square which turns into a cylinder and then into a circle, and they have to enact. Then is mirror images, in which we make pairs of children and one child becomes the mirror and the other child is supposed to act in or form certain images by looking into the mirror, and the mirror also has to enact the same because they are like a mirror image. And the other child then after some time will become the mirror, and the second child will become the will do the different activities which the now the mirror has to also copy. Then we can also include certain memory games, for example, name chain. Name chain is a game which also breaks the ice between the children. If the teacher is new, that time also she can use. For example, so if there are four children sitting together, so the first child, whose maybe name is A, tells his name. So he says A. The second child says, takes the name of the first child and then his or her own name. So A and then B. The third child has to take the name of the first, the second, and then hers or his name. So this way a chain will be formed and they can go on, it can go on with the whole class. Similarly, number games can be played. For example, we can ask them, one child will count, will do counting, and one child will count in English and the other will count in Hindi. These activities can be done in groups or individually. Group activities help children to understand, and for the teacher also to know the group dynamics. It will allow collective voices of the children to emerge because they will all come together and bring about a particular script. It will promote group cohesiveness because they will all be together. They would want to put up a great show in front of other children who are there. They will also together recall the story that has been narrated to them that they have to enact. And it will also give time for dialogue and reflection, because before they are going to enact, they are going to talk about the script. So they will give dialogues and they will reflect on why something was done. So a lot of group dynamics can be observed, and it can help the classroom to build up a strong group. Then for individual expression. So now, although a child is part of a group, but when he or she is enacting, apart from that, the child, his or her individuality is something that comes to the fore. So the individual expression gives confidence, It gives personal engagement in the whole process. It recreates the lived experiences of children who come from diverse backgrounds and contexts, brings about their own diversity, the differences in terms of language, you know, the kind of gender, their abilities and capabilities, because every child will be totally different when he or she would be on a stage, and that individuality is going to reflect on the stage. So we'll talk about role play. In this, we can ask children to spend 5 minutes thinking about what they would like to be. For example, we ask them to be the prime minister or any famous character, and then we ask them to act it out. We can also use acting in pairs. Think up a pair of characters, for example, two nurses, two astronauts in space, and they have to work out how to work together. So again, we can make them work in pairs. Then mime can also be used. Ask the children to find a boy or girl as a partner, collect a chair and find a place in the room. Each pair needs to improvise a scene where one person would be sitting in a chair and the other offering them a service. The only catch is that you are not allowed to speak. So one person who is getting a service done, the other person becomes a hairdresser or a dentist. So they have to perform the role that a dentist would do with the person who is sitting on the chair, and they don't have to speak. They have to just enact what they would be doing. They can watch each other's performance quickly and discuss which ones were more effective and why. This discussion is also very important. After every enactment, we can discuss with the whole class that which performance did they like the most, which was the performance in which the message was coming across clearly, which was very effective, which were the performance in which the two actors, they supported each other while they were doing the performance. So all these need to be discussed with the children. Improvisation. So we can give them these topics: that a primitive tribe in a remote area is visited for the first time by an outsider. So what will you see there? Your town is engulfed by nuclear radiation. Imagine what would happen. You live in the slums of downtown big city and you are trying to support your family. So apart from these, any situation can be given to the children and they can be asked to perform on any of these. So drama is an important means of stimulating creativity in problem solving. It can challenge students' perceptions about their world and about themselves, because many a times they have not thought about the ideas that we are going to give them to improvise on. Dramatic exploration can provide students with an outlet for emotions, thoughts and dreams that they might not otherwise have means to express. So maybe this is the time when they are actually getting a medium to express themselves. A student can, if only for a few moments, become another, explore a new role altogether, try out and experiment with various personal choices and solutions to a very real problem, problems from their day-to-day lives, or problems faced by characters in literature or even by historical figures. They may interpret those problems in any which way. They may want to do the same, or they want to bring a change to it and improvise it. This can happen in a safe atmosphere where actions and consequences can be examined, discussed in a very real sense experience, because the teacher and the facilitator is there also, remember? And there are other children also who are there to give their own opinions about it. Drama allows students to communicate with and understand others in new ways. So many a time they would see that side of their classmate which they have not seen. Drama also provides training in the very practical aspects of communication so necessary in today's increasingly information-centered world. Students who have participated in dramatic activities are less likely to have difficulty in speaking in public, because those inhibitions would be shed when they would be talking about improvising these in front of so many students and teachers in the classroom, will be more persuasive in their communication, both written and oral, will be better able to put themselves in other person's shoes. As I said, they would be better able to empathize and be able to relate with them, and they will have a more positive and a confident self-image, because the way they will put themselves across, it definitely gives a boost to their confidence and the self-image of theirs. And they look forward to such opportunities where they can express themselves in front of the teacher or other children in the classrooms. Participation in dramatic activity requires self-control and discipline that will serve the student well in all aspects of life. So this is the learning they get from it. Students in drama will learn to work together, to cooperate with each other, to find the best way for each member of a group to contribute, and listen to and accept the viewpoints and contributions of others. No art form is more truly collaborative than this. Drama is an important tool for preparing students to live and work in a world that is increasingly team-oriented rather than hierarchical, because there will be no hierarchies that would exist there. It will be a sheer teamwork that will take place. Drama also helps students develop tolerance and empathy. In order to play a role competently, an actor must be able to fully inhabit another's soul. An actor must be able to really understand how the world looks through another person's eyes. It can help build responsible global citizens, because we are going to give them topics to be improvised, which can vary and can include citizenship as well. It can reinforce the rest of the school curriculum as well, so it can be used in any other subject. Since communication and empathy are central to drama, a student who has explored, like in the drama classroom, will be better able to understand ideas. He will be able to put himself into the shoes of figures in history and literature to understand the way human beings interact. The link between dramatic arts and subjects such as English, history, social studies and related areas is very obvious. The study of literature would be impossible without drama. More importantly, drama can be used to promote active learning in any subject. It improves vocabulary, comprehension and aids in language development. Studies have shown again and again that this approach yields greater depth of understanding and a marked improvement in retention. In this way, drama accomplishes several goals at once, enriching students' school experiences through art as well as reinforcing traditional academics. Self-regulation. Young children are known for acting with impulse, so dramatic play is a great stepping stone for learning to self-regulate their emotions and actions. Interestingly, when children assign and accept roles in dramatic play, they are motivated to stick to them, thinking of them as rules to follow, their own rules. This way, they develop the ability to coordinate and plan with others as well as control their impulses. Language development. Dramatic play teaches and encourages expressive language because all the time they are expressing themselves. Children are motivated to communicate their wishes to their peers and therefore must learn to speak from the perspective of their pretend roles. Dramatic play is often a very comfortable place for children who are shy or withdrawn to participate in a group. Conflict resolution. Both unstructured and structured dramatic play offers teachable moments about conflict resolution. Inevitably, disagreements will naturally arise during dramatic play, which offers children a chance to work through their differences and arrange a compromise. It also encourages children to consider alternate perspectives as they recognize various roles of people in their lives and communities. It empowers children. Typically, when children act out dramatic or frightening experience, they place themselves in a powerful role. They choose to play a mommy or a daddy, two important figures in their lives, or a superhero with great powers. Thus, children develop accurate speech skills, oral presentation skills, reading ability, social skills through drama, and they become self-confident, good communicators, creative and expressive in their thoughts by using drama. Thank you.